Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Good morning. God bless you this morning. And as always, you know, we are using this music. We don't own the rights to it. But as always, we're going to use it to give just a little bit of praise. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Good morning, Sister Butler and Brother Butler. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Good to see you all. Good to see you all. As always, you know, like I say, you know, we don't own the rights to this music, but we like to use it to get a little bit of praise on. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My God, my God. Herein,
your presence, I am made new.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
So now,
glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God.
I pour out my...
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to get a little bit more of that before this is all over with. Amen. But again, we're so grateful to God to be here this morning. Amen. Let's look to the Lord in a word of prayer, and then we are going to get into the word of God so the word of God can get into us. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sister Carrie Reynolds. Glory to God. Good to see you this morning, young lady. Good to see you. Praise the Lord. Let's pray, y'all. Father, we thank you for your many blessings. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. We thank you for long suffering with your people right now, Father God. For you know, Lord, that we were born bent. We were even born broken right now, Father God. And throughout our lives, Father, we have faced, oh Heavenly Father, so many trials and so many temptations and so many scenarios where we have failed miserably. But you have been long suffering. You have been kind. You have been merciful. Oh, thank you, Lord, for looking beyond our faults and meeting us at the point of our needs. God, we thank you this morning. Oh, how we bless your name. Thank you, Lord, that you know us by name. You called us out of darkness into the marvelous light right now, Father God. And then you watch over us like a mother hen brood over her chicks right now. Oh, Lord, we thank you right now, God. We magnify you right now, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you right now for the blood of your son that came running down on Calvary's cross right now, picking up sin debt and sin tabs and washing them away and paying for them in full. Bless your name, oh God. Lord, we magnify you this morning. We praise you, Lord. Have your way in your word that we might find ourselves doing the will of God. Oh, Lord, we thank you. Oh, Lord, we bless you. And we magnify you today, Lord. Speak to our hearts as only you can. And we will be careful to give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless you this morning. I'm so glad and excited about Jesus Christ. Amen. There is a word from the Lord this morning. I don't want to hold you too long. I want to say good morning to everyone. Hello and how are you doing? Amen. So glad to see Sister Carrie logged in with us this morning. Girl, we thank God for you. We've been praying and fasting for the Lord to do a supernatural, mighty, miraculous work, and he's done it again. God bless you, my sister. Good to see you out there. Amen. Listen, family, this morning I need just a little bit of help. I'm going to ask somebody to type the title to this message out there for us this morning. I'm about to give it to you. Type this thing out for us this morning. We are in the book of Colossians chapter 1. Amen. And the title to this morning's message is Paul Commissioned by Christ. Paul Commissioned by Christ. Amen. That's the title of the message this morning, and it's from verses 24 through 29. I hope we're able to get through that. I can't promise you that we will, because there is a lot in this being commissioned. Amen. Paul is commissioned by Christ. He's been summoned. He's been called. Amen. God has chosen him. Come on over here. I'm going to use you. All right. The message this morning is entitled Paul Commissioned by Christ. Amen. Colossians chapter 1, verse 24 through 29. Amen. Under that, I got 3 points I want to talk to you about this morning in that commissioning by Christ. Number one, Paul is going to talk to us about the fact that he is sharing in the sufferings. Amen. He is sharing. I've been commissioned by Christ, and I got the privilege to share in his suffering. Number two, I've been commissioned by Christ, and then I get to share the secrets. I've been commissioned by Christ. I get to share the secrets. And then thirdly, but certainly last and not least, amen, I've been commissioned by Christ, and I get to share the Savior. I get to share the Savior. He's in me, I'm in him, and I get to share him with you. Somebody ought to say amen. Amen. Let's go ahead and let's get into this lesson this morning, y'all. So the first thing, Paul, he moves in to inform us that his suffering is because, my suffering, Paul says here, is because of the preeminence of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm going to read these verses for you, and then I'm going to show you this in the scripture. If you have your Bibles, by now you should have the Word of God, boom, opened up, ready to read. All right, here we go. Starting at verse 24. Verse 24 says, "Who now rejoice in my suffering for you, and I fill up that which is behind of the afflictions of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church." Verse 25, "Whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God." 26, "Even the mystery which have been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to the saints, to whom God would make what is the riches of the glory of his mystery among the Gentiles." To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is what? Christ in you, the hope of glory. Amen. Verse 28, "Whom we preach, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus." Last verse, "Whereunto I also labor, striving according to his working, which worketh in me mightily." That has been the reading of our text for this morning. Let's back up for a minute so we can go and unpack this thing. Amen. Let's go get them, y'all. Verse 24, he says, "Who now is in my suffering? Who now rejoice? Who now rejoice in my sufferings for you? Who now rejoice in my sufferings for you?" See, Paul was not sad. He wasn't disappointed. Neither nor was he regretting his suffering. No. He was rejoicing in the fact that he was counted worthy to suffer shame for the sake of Christ for the brothers and the sisters. Come on. He was rejoicing in the fact that he got an opportunity to fellowship in the sufferings of Jesus Christ. And he said to the Colossian church, "I'm glad to do that for you and me, my brothers and sisters, because I've been commissioned by Christ. I'm glad to be able to suffer for his sake." He says this next. And fill up that which is behind of the affliction of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church. Now, what is he saying here, my brothers and sisters? He's telling us that he's going to fulfill the commission that's been given to him, the commission that's been left behind for me, Paul is saying. I'm going to continue to share in the sufferings of my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm going to take up my cross and I'm finna get busy. Every day I'm going to follow the Lord. I'm taking up the cross. I'm taking up the mantle and I'm going to keep on fulfilling that which was left behind for me. Now listen. This what he's saying here is I get a chance to. I get an opportunity to. I get a chance to. I get to get rejected. I get to get denied. I get to get abused now. I get to get misused. I get to get mistreated because I get to take up that cross every day and follow him. And Paul is saying, and I'm not disappointed. I'm not mad. I'm not upset. I rejoice. I'm glad about it. I get to present my body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God for his body, who is who? The church. And I thank God for it. Amen. It's a privilege, Paul is saying. It is a privilege. Listen, here's my disclaimer for you. Now, here's my disclaimer. The sufferings and the afflictions of Paul had nothing to do with the sacrificial sufferings of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on that cross. That's not what he's saying. He is only, here's it, because he is the only sinless Lamb of God that could have died for the sins of the world. He's the only one. And so Paul don't want you to get that misunderstanding. Paul is just simply saying to you that my suffering is the suffering of one of the go ye therefores. You with me? I just get to suffer as one of the go ye therefores and teach them all nations. I'm baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I get to suffer, and that's my portion of the suffering. I get to follow in the afflictions of Christ Jesus. I get to continue to fulfill my mission. That's what he's saying here. Amen? Matthew chapter 28. Now, let's go on, my brothers and sisters. Not only do I get to share in the sufferings, but I get to share this sacred secret with you. I get to share the secrets of God with the brothers and sisters, with the body of Christ. And he's excited about it. Verse 25, whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God. Amen. The administration of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God. Boy, that's a beautiful thing. What Paul is saying here, y'all, he said, listen, I've been ordained and commissioned to minister, to serve, to wait on you like a waiter wait on the table. I've been commissioned for this job. I've been commissioned to serve. I've been commissioned to wait on. I've been commissioned to minister. I've been commissioned to be on the bottom, and I'm glad about it. For this purpose that my life got purpose. Amen. Before I was in sin, I was sinking deep in sin, and I was far from the peaceful shore. I was lost, and I was out there. My destination was doomed. And Paul said what he did, y'all. He came and he got me, he commissioned me, and he gave my life purpose. He gave my life meaning. And now I'm living with intention. I'm intentionally living. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I got purpose in my life. And I'm intentionally living right now. And for what sake? For what sake, you might add? To fulfill the word of God. I'm intentionally living. That's what he's saying. Excuse me for a moment. Paul, what word of God are you fulfilling right now? That's my question. Paul, what word of God are you fulfilling right now? Paul says this. Even that word, even the mystery, which had been hid from ages and from generations, but now it's been made manifest to the saints. Verse 27 and 26 go together. To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. What he's saying, listen, I get to share the mystery. I get to impart the mystery to you. I get to communicate it. I get to pass it on and to convey the mystery that has been hidden from ages and from generations in time past. And I get the privilege to share the mystery with you, my brothers and sisters. See, the false teachers of Paul's day, they used to use that word mystery all the time. And often they use it to describe the inner secrets of their religion. They use this word mystery just to describe the inner secrets of their religion. But when Paul used the word mystery, it means to reveal to you a sacred secret hidden in the past. And now it has been revealed by the Holy Spirit. And Paul said, and God used me to do it. And I'm glad about it. Lord have mercy, Jesus. Amen. So I want you to allow me for a minute just to take you to the book of Ephesians, to the book of Ephesians chapter 3. Amen. Somebody put the book of Ephesians chapter 3 verses 1 through 13. Amen. The book of Ephesians chapter 3 verses 1 through 13. Good morning. Good to see all of you. Amen. God bless your family. We're going to the book of Ephesians chapter 3 verse 1 through 13. Because here's what I believe. I'm going to give you a chance to get your Bible over there. It ain't too many pages back there, but get that Bible and get a chance to move back over there. Listen, allow me to help you to understand one thing about the Word of God. I believe that the Word of God does the best job at explaining the Word of God. Somebody ought to say amen. Let the Word explain the Word. Amen. The book of Ephesians, chapter 3. Thank you, Sister Camille. Chapter 3, verses 1 through 13. Amen. Here we go, brothers and sisters. Here we go. If you have it, let's listen to what the Word says. Paul says in here, for this cause I, Paul, the prisoner of Jesus Christ. Ephesians chapter 3 now. He say, I'm a prisoner. Now over there in Colossians, he was saying he was a servant. Over here in Ephesians, he said, a minister. Over here in Ephesians, he said, I'm a prisoner. I'm on house arrest for my Lord and Savior. Yes, sir. Listen, y'all. So Paul said, I'm a prisoner of Jesus Christ for you Gentiles. You see that? Watch what he says. Now, he's explaining to us now the mystery of the sacred secret. Amen. Good to see you this morning, grandmother. God bless you. Verse number 2. If you have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God, the administration, God's business, his economy of the grace of God, which is given to me toward you. That's what he's saying. If God have given me this economy that God has, he has given me his grace for you. All right? Now, how that by making known unto me the mystery, the sacred secret, as I wrote it just in a few words, just a little bit. I just briefly told you about it. Now here, let me elaborate just a little bit, is what Paul is saying. Whereby when you read, you may understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ. Help me, Lord. He says, watch what he said. Which in other ages, in other times, in time past, in other eras, amen, was not made known unto the sons of men. See, let me come on. As it is now revealed unto his holy apostles by the prophets, by the Spirit. To his holy apostles and prophets by the Holy Spirit. Amen. It wasn't known unto them. And it has now been made known unto us, his holy apostles, his holy prophets, by the Spirit. I told you this sacred secret came by the Holy Spirit. And it's been made known to us by the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost has revealed this sacred secret to us. Guess what? Adam didn't have it. Noah didn't know anything about it. Abraham kind of saw it a little glimmerly like. Isaac and Jacob and none of they didn't know anything. They couldn't see this thing. Moses could not. It's like looking in a dark mirror, a rearview mirror that's fogged all up. You can see something coming, but I don't know what it is. I said something right there. I can see something coming, but I don't know what it is because it's foggy right now. The Hebrew writer said it was a shadow, and I just can't make out the real image. And Paul said the Holy Ghost has revealed it unto us. He has revealed it unto his apostles and his prophets, and it came to us by way of the Holy Spirit. And God, through his grace, showed it to us. Somebody ought to say amen. Let's look more into this thing. That the Gentiles, what is the sacred secret? Here it is. That the Gentiles should be fellow heirs. That they should be fellow heirs. They should be sons and daughters and of the same body. The arms, the hands, the legs, the feet. I said the Gentiles, them ones that were far off, the ones that wasn't a part of the commonwealth, the ones that were not a part of, didn't have no hope in the world, didn't have no God in their world. And Jesus Christ said, I got a sacred secret for you, and I'm going to give it to you by the Holy Ghost. The Gentiles going to get to be fellow heirs, and they're going to be a part of this body. Somebody ought to say amen. Help me up in here, Holy Ghost. Oh, I love the Lord. He heard my cry and he pitied every groan. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, brothers and sisters. So he goes on and said, the Gentiles are going to be partakers of this, of the promise of Jesus Christ by the gospel. It came by way of the good news of Jesus Christ. It came by way of the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ. And when you get that gospel down in you, that Jesus Christ died on the cross, and he stayed in the grave for 3 days, and on the third day he got up with all power in his hand, and anybody believe on him can be made new. They can have new life by believing in Jesus Christ. You can be saved from your sin and inherit eternal life and become heirs of the promise, because Jesus Christ, what did he do? Died on the cross and rose again for the sake of the Gentiles, and gave us, for the sake of all men, and gave us the right to become the sons and daughters of God. Listen, it get better. It get better. It get gooder, as they say. Now, Paul said, whereof? Paul says, I am made a minister. I'm made a servant. You understand what I'm saying? First, he said, I'm a prisoner. Now, he's saying, I'm a servant. Then he turned around and said, listen, I'm a slave to this thing. And then, remember, I told you, he said, I'm a waiter. It's just like me waiting table. I got a job here to do. My life is lived intentional. I have intent. I got purpose in my life. God done made me a minister. I am a part of the administration of the divine, and I'm glad about it. Amen, amen. So he said, not only that, I've been made a minister according to the gift of the grace of God given unto me by the effectual working of his power. God empowered me. God endorsed me. God called me. God qualified me. God summoned me by his power. And if God called me, can't nobody do nothing about it. Elsewise, you'll find yourself fighting against the living God. Come on, somebody. Listen. Unto me, who am the least. Paul, he realized, he humbles himself. Unto me, who am the least, I am less than the least of all the saints. I don't even deserve this. I was running around killing Christians. You understand me? I was sitting right there when the brother was being stoned, and I was holding coats for him. I don't deserve any of this, man. Listen, I was running around there trying to live my own righteousness by the law. I don't deserve any of this, amen. But God, who has given this thing to me, who have less than the least of all the saints, I'm the one on the bottom. Paul said, if I'm a part of the body, I'm the bottom of the foot. I'm least and the less. I'm the most, Paul is saying to us, I'm the most unimportant part of the body, but God chose me by his own administration anyway. Somebody ought to say amen. So don't ever think that God can't use you. Amen. Because God can use you no matter how insufficient you might feel about you. God can still use you. Oh, somebody ought to hear what I'm saying this morning. God will use you for his administration to bring many sons to glory. God will use you when you feel insignificant and unimportant. God will still use you. God will use you to bring tens, hundreds, thousands to him. And your life can change a generation. Don't you ever think that God can't use you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Listen, Paul said, I'm less than least of all the saints. Is this grace given? Is this grace given to me that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable, the unfathomable, the unknowable riches of Christ? You can know Christ. Listen, you can know Christ for sure. You can know him for sure and be compelled, but you can't know him completely. You'll never fully know all there is to know about Jesus Christ. That's why he said these are unsearchable riches of Christ. All right? You can know him truly. I say it all the time. But you'll never know Jesus Christ fully. God bless you. Keep striving. Keep searching. Keep reading the word. Keep seeking his face. Amen? But you'll never know all there is to know about Jesus Christ. I believe the book of John, the writer of John said, and if we had books that went from here to heaven, it still wouldn't be enough to tell about all the things that Jesus did. Amen? So you'll never know him fully and completely. He's unsearchable. I got to go on and tell you some more about this. Ephesians chapter 3 chapter here. He says in verse 9, and to make all men, watch this, and to make all men see what is the fellowship of the mystery. What is the fellowship of the mystery? Which from the beginning of the world have been hid in God, who created all things in by Jesus Christ. The fellowship is also the administration of stewardship. That's what he's saying. This fellowship is also an administration of stewardship. Amen. And God, what God has done, has given this thing to us, and it was hid in Jesus Christ, who created all things by Jesus Christ. Amen. Verse number 10, to the intent. Here's the reason. To the intent that now unto the principalities and the power. Now catch this. Catch this, brothers and sisters. He said that now to the intent that the principalities, those rulers and those powers, those in authority in heavenly places, these celestial and the terrestrial bodies. And you better listen closely to what I'm saying. I'm going to slow down because I want you to hear this. The celestial and the terrestrial bodies, heavenly places, might be known, listen at that, by the church, the manifold wisdom of God. What am I telling you? I'm telling you that God hid this sacred secret from heaven, and he only revealed it to the church. Somebody ought to say amen. God kept this sacred secret, a mystery that he was going to bring the Gentiles in by the blood of Jesus Christ, and not even heaven knew it. It was decided in the foreordained counsel of God. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. And no principalities and no powers, not even in heaven, knew this. And it was made known to them by the church. That's what the Bible says. Amen. That's God's word. Praise the Lord. According to his, verse 11, according to his eternal purpose, which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord. And according to his purpose, by his own will, by his own decree, by his own decision, and he purposed it in his son Jesus Christ, who he laid his weight on, somebody. He said, my son, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. The only person that God revealed all his secrets to is his son, Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ knows about it. Amen. Here we are, brothers and sisters. Now, verse 12. We're coming to a close in this particular passage of scripture. This is from Ephesians chapter 3. He says, in whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him. In whom we have boldness, listen at that, and access Boldness is also known as courage. Now I can take heart and I can take courage. I got confidence and now I can stand firm in my trust of him. By the faith of him, I've got faith in him and through him. My faith is both in him. I got confidence. I got boldness. I got courage. I can take heart. I can walk right into the holies of holies because I got faith in him, through him, by him. Amen, somebody. Wherefore, I desire that ye faint not. So you bet not faint. Hold your head up. Go wash your face. Get yourself together. Drink you some cold water. Listen, man, and don't you faint. Don't you faint not at my tribulation. You hear what Paul just said? The same thing he's saying in Ephesians, the same thing he's saying over in Colossians. I rejoice in my suffering. Don't you get faint. Don't you lose heart because I'm going through tribulation for you. I don't mind. It don't bother me. I'm not regretting it. So don't you regret it. Don't you lose heart about it. Don't you get upset about it. And don't you give up about it. Because I'm not hurt about it. So why you hurt about it? Lord have mercy. The brother is preaching, y'all. The brother is preaching. And he tells them, he says, which is your glory? This is for glory. God is getting a praise through this. God is being magnified through what's going on. He is being pleased. He's pleased by the suffering of me suffering with his son. So if I don't lose heart, you don't lose heart. If I ain't troubled by it, you don't get troubled by it. If it don't perplex me, don't let it perplex you. If it don't bother me, don't let it bother you. Because God is getting the glory in this thing. Somebody ought to say amen. So don't you give up. Don't you get upset. Because my suffering and my affliction, my shame is for your shout. Ha! Somebody ought to say amen. My shame is for your shout. One day, when you are glorified and I am glorified, don't make me start that again, y'all. When you get yours and I get mine and you get your robe and I get my robe and we standing there in glory together, you're going to experience the riches of his glory. One day, brothers and sisters, when we stand before him, we both going to be singing hallelujah to the king and to the lamb. Glory, 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 hallelujah. His truth is marching on. Amen, somebody. His truth is marching on. And when you stand there and you're going to say just like I'm going to say, glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is indeed marching on. And so, y'all, here's the thing. So when we're going through our suffering, when we're going through these things, remember that if we suffer with him, we're going to reign with him. That's what Paul's saying. So you hang on in there. Because there is one day coming, finally, that we're going to experience the hope of glory. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Listen, y'all, I'm gonna have to load this last point up. I'm gonna load this last point up for you at another time. God, I get excited in this word. I'm gonna load this last point. This last point was we're gonna talk about, and you may just kind of watch our page, and you'll see sharing the Savior. He gets an opportunity to share the Savior. But as I promised y'all before we go, I want to get a little bit more of that praise on. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. How he walks with me, yes he does.
Oh, how, you talk,
how he talks with me.
Oh, how you tell me.
He tells me
I
that I am his own. Can you hear me out there? Ha! Trust you, Lord, with my whole life. Glory, God. Praise the Lord. Listen, y'all. Listen, y'all know me. I never like to leave a fellowship. Amen. Yes, ma'am. We don't own the rights to that music, but you know we always use it to get our praise on. Amen. Listen, y'all know I don't ever like to leave a fellowship without offering somebody the opportunity to get to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Amen. This may be the last day of the last day. Amen. Somebody say, oh, we living for the last days. Well, this might be your last day. Amen. And so I don't like to take that for granted, that somebody needs to get to know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Amen. So y'all listen. I'm going to take you to this throne of grace here in just a second. But first, before I go there, I want to offer you something. I want to extend you an invitation. I want you to come to get to know me. You understand what I'm saying? Listen, so let me tell you something. Man, don't you be ashamed. Don't be afraid. Don't be bashful. Don't feel bad. Don't regret it. Because the Bible said that we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All mean all. Every one of us. Amen. There is nobody that's on this line, on this feed. There's nobody that you look at work or at home or at school or anywhere that have not sinned. We all have done it. There was not but one perfect, sinless Lamb of God, and His name is Jesus Christ. But I got to be honest with you, brothers and sisters. Because of that sin, it's lawlessness, because we have broken God's law, because we have, and we got to be honest, we have fell short of the mark of God's holy standard of righteousness, then what happens is God said, I'm still a judge, and because I am a judge, I got to execute justice. You know what I'm saying? A good judge going to execute justice, whether it's in your favor or not. He got to execute justice now. That's just the truth of the matter, whether you want to receive that or not. And the thing of it is, because God is a good judge, here's what He said. The wages of sin, the payment for sin, the compensation for sin is death. Now, I'm not going to sit here and try to sugarcoat this thing for you, so don't think I am. I'm going to tell you the straight truth because I want you to make a real sound decision based on wisdom. Amen. So here's the thing about that death. This is not a go to the cemetery and bury me death. This death right here that we're talking about, this is a Revelation 20:21 death, amen, where God is going to cast Satan, the false prophet, the beast, hell, the grave, death, all of those into what is known as the lake of fire. And the Bible declares that they will burn for all eternity, ages without end. Now, anybody, I'm just telling you now, the wages of sin is death. So the payment for your sin is death. And that's the debt that He is speaking of. That is going to be your compensation package because we sinned or we violated God's holiness. Now, here's what it said in that same chapter in verse. It says this, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. This is what's amazing. Now, this is the gospel. This is what's amazing about that. Because on one hand, God is a judge, right? And He executes justice. But on the other hand, God is a loving, caring, giving God. It's amazing the dualistic nature that God has. He has manifold wisdom. So He knows how to judge and execute justice. But at the same time, He knows how to love and to give and to be merciful. So I want to tell you this right now. Here's what He says in that second part. But the gift of God. The gift of God. It's a gift. A gift means that somebody gave it to you, right? You didn't buy it. You didn't work for it. You didn't pay for it. Matter of fact, if truth had to be told, you don't have enough money to even buy this gift. It's a gift that's inexhaustible. It's inexpensive. I say inexpensive. It's more valuable. It's invaluable is the word. Invaluable. So it has more value than you could ever care to pay for or compensate. God said, I'm going to gift that gift to you. I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to grant it to you. The gift of God is, here's the gift, eternal life. Now, remember, the first part said you got death, the death. But here in the second part of the verse, He said, I'm going to give you eternal life. I'm going to gift it to you. Here's the thing. I want to encourage you. You need to take a strong decision this morning and receive and accept the gift of God, which is eternal life with Him, ages. We just read over in the book of Ephesians how that you will be an heir, a part of the body. You need to get this gift, man. You got to accept this gift today. Don't let today become tomorrow without you accepting this gift now. So you say, Pastor, well, tell me how to get the gift, man. You're talking so much about it. Oh, okay, well, let me tell you how to get the gift. So here's how you get the gift. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 3:16, he says, for God so loved, that love is agape love, that's love in spite of yourself. That's what Romans says, that God demonstrated, he commended his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for you. So God loved you so much that he was willing to do your best while you was doing your worst. Somebody ought to say amen. Amen. So God so loved the world that he gave, that word is again, a gift. He granted to you that he gave his only begotten son. That's Jesus Christ. He said, I'm going to give my son. Hear what he done. I'm going to give my son. In that giving of his son, what he's saying, I'm going to give my son for your life. And then here's what I want. I'm going to give my son for your life, and then you give me your life. It's an exchange of life, a life for a life. So I'm going to give my son. He's going to go down on the cross for your sins. And then what you got to do is you got to, in turn, give me your life. Okay? That's the exchange. It's a fair exchange. Well, actually, it's not a fair exchange. Amen? Because his life is more valuable, more precious, because God put his whole weight on Jesus Christ. So he really, for us, remember now, we were already doomed and destined for sin. So our life really is worthless because we were already destined to die and go to hell because of our sin anyway. So God came, he did something supernatural. He said, I'm going to give you something priceless for something worthless. Man, that's amazing. And that's what he did. So God, he said, here's what, I'm going to give you my son, Jesus Christ. And what Jesus Christ does, here's what happened. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Now here's your word. Whosoever believeth in him, shall not perish but have everlasting life. What is he saying right there? He's saying, believe, that word believe, go with the word receive. I believe him. I receive him. I accept him. He is mine. I put my trust in him, my hope in him, my confidence in him. I lean on him. I lay on him. Just like God put his weight on Jesus. Guess what? Jonathan Wood's going to put his weight on Jesus too. And I'm encouraging you today. Put your weight on Jesus, man. And here's what happened. You put your weight on Jesus, God say, and then you'll get everlasting life. Why? Because you exchanged a life for a life. And you put your weight on Jesus. So I want to encourage you today. If you have made that your choice, if you have not made that your decision, you want to do that right now today. I want to pray for you. If you made that your choice, if you made that your decision, I want to bless God for you. I want to thank God for this new convert that has come to know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Then I want to encourage you. Now, you know, you got to begin to get into Bible feeding or intake God's word. You need to come to these websites like this, or come to Facebook. You know, I'm here every Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. I'm here on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. And you know, I'm gonna teach you straight out the Bible. You know that, right? Amen. Go back, you can see some of my other posts on Facebook. I go word for word, line for line, text for text. I don't put my own stuff in. I just give it to you as it is, the word of God. Amen. So you need to find a place where you're getting trained, you're getting taught, you're learning the word of God. Amen. And so I want to encourage you today to come to know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Let's pray, brothers and sisters. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you for all those who are on this other side of this feed today, Lord. I want to thank you for your wisdom. I want to thank you for your knowledge and your understanding. But more than anything, I want to thank you that they have made Jesus the Lord of their life. I thank you right now, Father God, that you have helped them to make a choice and a decision to walk out of sin into the marvelous light, to come out of darkness into light, to come from sin to righteousness, to come from death to life. I thank you for my brothers and sisters who have made Jesus their choice to live their life in a newness of life and to serve the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, I bless them right now. I ask you to go before them. Let them find places where they can be taught. Find people to be around to help to support them, to help them right now in this time of the COVID-19 where there is separation, but we can still be close right now, Father God, through connective platforms like this right now, Father God. We thank you for this platform. We thank you for the converts. I thank you for all of those at Christ Mission who have joined and logged in this morning. Continue to go with them, Lord. We thank you for your blessings of healing and mercy for our own dear sister, Carrie. And we thank you for her being online with us this morning, Lord God. Lord, I thank you for my brothers and sisters who continue to do the work of the Lord, even amidst, and to have faith in you, even in the midst of troubles and trials. We bless your name. We give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. brothers and sisters, I love you so much. Listen, as always, I'm getting ready to roll out. You know what I'm saying? So God bless you. You go with God, because God has always gone with you. And I'm out.